All right, I was going to try and do this on conventional, this link pin retainer clip. And what I'm trying to do is do it in some stainless, which is the only material that I have, unless I went through the trouble of making some round stock or whatever. But I parted it off a ways at 40 thou. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drill the holes in for the little clip pins. We'll see if I can get the holes in there, and if I can get it parted off straight. It looks pretty good. So we're just going to set that in here. I'm going to set it on a parallel. That. Clamp her up. I got both ends face so it'll sit square. Should sit square to the world. Tighten that up. And what I did was got the dimensions, and I'll drill the holes first. 156 diameter. So I need to dial in the center first. First off, I get my indicator. It's over here on the NC mill yet. All right. You know what? I'm gonna take that chuck out to do this. So that I can put this right in the collet. And I can raise the table up then. So the table is so far down. Good. And can I get on the other side here and still not be in the way? Hopefully I'm not in the way of the camera. Got the diameter turn, the OD turn. And I, like I say, I started parting it off with the part off blade just to see how it was going to go in the stainless. I'm not sure exactly how it is going to go. Stainless is a bugger to work with. I do have carbide part off blade. I might have to switch to that. I got the tripod sitting right up against the the mill, so I kind of bumped it there.
Ten above.
And that's about what it is outside.
Ten above.
No, I think it's 15. I think it's 15 above outside. It was 14 when I got up. That went up a whole degree. Right. Be looking over my shoulder, I hope. I think I'll move the camera. I think I'll move it over to my left somewhere here. Alright. Bear with me. Zoom in a little bit. All right. I shouldn't be in the way.
Off to the right.
Okay. Unplug my other camera. The one that doesn't know how to focus. Oh, that irritates me. When it starts going, doing the focus dance. All right, so I'm going to do the two up here first. So it's 485 up on Y. 485. When we get this clip done, this works, then we'll start on pistons. 353 advance.
might be a little bit further than that cutoff blade. I think I'm hoping that my tool won't hit it and go walking off. And the diameter that we want is 156. I could take a 156 end mill. Well, we'll just see what happens. I'll take a chance. That's one bad thing about Albright chucks. Some, if you don't get them on the inside, if they get too much grease in there, they do that. Yep, pushed it off. Ah, darn it. Shoved it right off that way. I knew I should have went about 56 angle. Darn it. That means they face all that off. Well, if I'm careful and line it up right, I can do that 56 and then come straight out. Well, let's see if I can get 56. Can't read the numbers on the smaller mills like that. Yeah, you don't want to screw this up. Those pins got to be held in place. If you don't hold them in place, well, good. Is that right? 5/32. I'm trying to read the end. Yep, 5/32. It's a two-fluter carbide. Let's try. And normally, like I say, I don't like putting them in a chuck, but I am going to plunge, but it is going to put side pressure on. I'm going to actually slow the RPM down. That's why I pushed off a little bit too. Okay. Here we go. should still work if I line that up correctly, but I'm milling the slot out. All right, so let's go over 353 on the other side here. So we'll just go with the center drill and then the end drill. Let's see, what size is this new metal body? Oh, that's 187. We do not want to go that. It's only 40 thou thick, so. All right, so now let's get on the other side. On y-axis, it'd be 185. On y. Oops, went shot by it. And 571. I'm hoping that when I part it off, too, it doesn't cup on me. Let's go a little deeper with this. Okay. boy. I think I broke the corner off the annual. Yep, I chipped it. I'm gonna go and see if I can hand sharpen it good enough to finish what we're doing here. As long as I get to the grinder. Hand sharpening an end of an anvil is not an easy task. For me, anyway. Oop, wheel spinning the wrong way, naturally. I want it spinning the other way. And then this light, I've got a light, but it just never wants to stay put where you want it. All right, here we go. First off, I'm going to try to square up the end past where the food gets off. Never to cut again, right? Well, I could almost quit. My tool grinding. Set up. I'll sharpen it. Looking pretty ugly. Gotta remember, it doesn't have to cut in the center. Only out on the food. Just about got it. If it would have been a 4-flute, I'd have had a better chance at that. Not sharpen it at this. Let's blow that out in case that piece of carbide is in there. Stuck it there somewhere. Seems to be cutting. I think that's far enough. Alright. I think I'm beyond it. Alright, let's put this in our drill lathe that we never used. That we used once and may have screwed this up. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn it to where if on X-axis. I think that's going to pan out for me. And then come over here and try to get somewhat close to the hole. Again. And then slowly move across. back to the NC idea instead. Take a piece of square coal roller and you have to be careful when I come off the end of this. I don't like doing this in a drill cut. Got a slot out, but I'll try to line up the next one. Let's see if we can find the hole. Right there. Such a simple looking part, you know, is actually not very simple. You come right down to it. Of course, then I'm compounding it by using stainless. I should have just used brass. Brass would have probably been fine. That are just about that size too, but I don't want to definitely want to use the copper. That's why I wanted stainless. I wanted something a little harder on that for that clip. I didn't go too bad. Now this is the one we hooked up. Say that boogered up because we had a co-worker booger.
good duck crew nickname. The 156 end mill gives that those pins about 6 thou clearance to slide in there in these slots. We'll grab one of those pins and we'll see what we get here. This is a jog in it.